Welcome everybody. My name is Lars Brunjes. I'm the Director of Education at IOHK, and in this short video I want to help you get started with YELLE, the language designed by runtime verification to power smart contracts on Cardano. We'll look at a very simple example of a program written in YELLE and show how to deploy it to the YELLE testnet. You can of course write YELLE from scratch, but to begin it's maybe easier to start with a contract written in Solidity, compile it to YELLE and then look at the resulting code and modify it. So we'll do just that, and as an example I'll take the same example I used in another video where I showed how to compile Solidity using the command line tool mallet and then deploy it on the YELLE testnet. So let's briefly look at this simple contract. It's called counter. It has one int variable x of state. The constructor sets x to 0, and there are two functions, one to increment x by a given increment a, and the other to return the value of x. Let's compile. We do that with mallet connecting to the YELLE testnet, and the command is yelle.compile. It takes the file name, let's check the result. And there we see the field YELLE code, which contains the Solidity contract compiled to YELLE. So in order to save that, we use Node.js fs write file. File name, let's call it counter.yelle. We use c.yelle code. And we must provide an error handler, but we don't expect any errors. So let's do it like this. Let's check. And there we are. Let's look at this in editor. So I'm starting Vim. Okay, so first of all we noticed that this is actually quite easy to read. At least it's much more easy to read YELLE than it is to read EVM. And we can see the structure of our original Solidity contract. So we have the contract name, we have the store variable X, we have the constructor, the increment function and the getX function. So let's look at that in a bit more detail. So this status variable X is indicated with an at symbol. Then function names also preceded by an at. Then we have labels in this function. In the constructor we have three: entry, return and throw. So labels are the destinations of branching statements. Here in the first line we have a local variable, a register, prefixed with a percentage sign, and we assign to this register call value the result of calling the special function YELLE call value, which returns the value of the transaction. So register call value now contains the value of the transaction. And in this line we do a conditional branch. So it takes two arguments, the variable to base the condition on and the label where to jump to. So if this is greater than zero, so if this transaction has a value, then we jump to label throw, which is down here. and we revert. So we expect it to be zero. In that case, nothing will happen. And we reach this line where store variable x, this one here, our counter, is set to zero. So the constructor first checks whether the transaction value is zero, and if it is, it sets x to zero, otherwise it reverts. And after setting x to zero, it returns void nothing. In the increment function, we have an argument to the function, also indicated with this percentage sign, called a0. We again check that no value is transferred, otherwise we revert here. Then we introduce a register x.val, load the value of x into it, introduce a second register tmp, and assign the sum of register xval and a0 to it, and xval has the value of x, so temp now contains the sum of x and the argument to the function a0, and then finally we store this sum back into x, and we return void. Finally, in the getX function, again we check that no value is transferred, otherwise we jump to throw and revert. We load the value of x into register x.val. We introduce a second register _1, assign to it x.val. Then we jump to label return. This now only has one argument, so it's an unconditional jump. It will always jump, so it jumps to this line and returns the value of register _1, which is the value of x.val, which is the value of x, as expected. Now that we understand how this works, let's try to improve on it a bit. First of all, the double quotes around the names are only necessary to escape special characters, so as long as we stick with simple names, they are not necessary. So let's get rid of all the double quotes. And simplify the names. We call this simply counter, this simply inc x, this simply get x. Then the variable names we can also improve, so here instead of a0 we just call it a, instead of x while just call it x, instead of temp give it a clearer name sum, down here same. Okay, so now that we have renamed the registers, let's look at other things. For example, the labels. To these entry labels, we don't need them because we never jump to them. We do jump to the throw, so we leave that, but we don't jump to this return statement, so we can get rid of that. Same here. Here we actually do jump to the return statement, but it's an unconditional jump, and as you can see, you just jump from this line to the very next line, so we can get rid of all three. We remove the jump and the label. And then there is one final thing we can do. This _1 is unnecessary. Here we load the value of x into the register x, then we load the value of the register x into register _1, and then we return _1. So we can simply return x directly and get rid of this one. Now that we are happy with the yellow code, let's generate bytecode. So we fire up mallet again. And we again use YLE compile, only this time we give our YLE file as source. Okay, and c.result is the bytecode we want. But just for fun, let's compare this with the bytecode we would have gotten if we had used the original version. So let's compare that with YLE compile, where we compile the solidity and grab the bytecode. And let's not overwrite our C. And we see that was much longer. So our hand optimization indeed made the resulting code shorter and cheaper and faster. Now that we have the bytecode, let's quickly deploy and test the smart contract. So in Mallet, I first have to select an account. So I simply list all accounts, grab the first one and select that. Now I use YLE create contract, where I have to specify some gas. Let's use 100,000. Then the value 0, and most importantly the code, which is just our C result. I must provide the password for the account, and let's grab the receipt in order to get to the contract address. It's not available yet. There it is. So the contract address is r.contractAddress. Right, now we have deployed the contract, now we can test it. So let's first increment the counter. YLE contract call, specify the contract address with this now counter, some guess, let's again use 100,000, value again 0. Now I need the function name, which is incx, and finally the arguments. So if we want to increment by 7, we use this. Again, my password. Let's wait for the receipt to see whether call succeeded. Okay, status code is 0, so it succeeded. Now, finally, let's call getX to check whether the counter is now indeed on 7. So, for that function, I don't need arguments. Password again. Get receipt. Let's grab the result. Okay, and in the return data the 7 is encoded, so if I want to decode that, I can require the RLP library and use its decode function applied to r.returnData. And there we go, 7. So we deployed the contract and we tested it and it seems to work. So to summarize, we have seen how to compile a Solidity contract to YLE. We have walked through some very simple example and seen the most important commands, like using local registers, assigning values to them, branching conditionally, adding numbers, returning values. We have seen how you can optimize YLE code, make the resulting bytecode smaller and faster, and we have seen how to deploy such a smart contract to the YLE testnet. And of course, we have only scratched the surface, so if you want to find out more about YLE, you should have a look at the homepage at Runtime Verification, YLE Semantics on GitHub, and there you find lots of information like the complete syntax, the design decisions made, and a lot of more interesting things.